Settle down, Lynn Bramer. It's time for the big show. Live from Carlucci, it's the XRT Breakfast with Bramer podcast, starring Chris Difford and Glenn Tilbrook of Squeeze. And now, here's Lynn Bramer.
And good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning, Kurt Rivera. Good morning, WFLD, Channel 32, Fox 32, radio, TV. It's all some harmonic convergence of chaos. And we know what Nietzsche said about chaos. He said, it's a very good thing. Breakfast with Bramer broadcast. We would like to welcome a couple of our friends, Chris Difford, Glenn Tilbrook of Squeeze.
Good morning.
Morning. And it does feel good to be alive, doesn't it?
It is great to be alive, Glenn. I'm glad you reminded me. I almost forgot, but it is great to be alive. And we're going to take some questions from the audience. And first off, we'd like to welcome, how about a hand for Kurt Rivera, Fox 32.
Hey, Kurt.
Good day, Chicago. He is here. He is on stage. That is a very special moment in Kurt's life. Kurt, why don't you start off by asking these guys a question? But I know you're on television, but step up to the radio microphone so you're like a double microphone kind of guy right now.
Yes, I am a double microphone kind of guy. And first off, Chris and Glenn, I know you guys started back in, 1978 or so?
Mm-hmm.
And I remember when you guys first came out, you know, punk rock was the rage, and then New Wave, you guys were the big thing. How have you survived for so long now?
I took the nipples out of my, the earrings out of my nipples.
It was right on my mind.
That's how I survived all these years. The pains have subsided somewhat.
Glenn, how about you? How have you survived all these years? Because I've watched your attempts at survival, and I sometimes question them.
Actually, I'm having the rings removed from my nipples next week. It's about time I made that transition.
And be listening for that big promotion where a lucky listener gets to remove the nipple rings from Glenn.
That'll be
exciting. Ouch, that really kind of hurts. Another question, Kurt?
You answered it right there.
We are all set to
Let's
go.
Hear some of the audience questions.
We're going to go out. This is always one of my favorite parts because it imparts so much danger to the radio program. We're going out live to the audience and Mary Dixon with a question for our friends here, Difford and Tilbrook.
You bet. And the question comes from Loretta Nemovic. All right, Loretta, hit it.
I'd like to know, how did the band Squeeze get its name?
I've always wondered that myself.
It's an interesting one.
There was when we were deciding to have our band, we were very much listening to the Velvet Underground at the time. So our idea of a little joke was to name ourselves after the Velvet Underground's worst album, the one after Lou Reed and John Cale left, and it was an awful album called Squeeze. So there we have it, and somehow it stuck.
All right.
We have another.
That was a good question. I enjoyed that question. Difford and Tilbrook, Squeeze, two sold-out 93 XRT shows. You can't get a ticket if you want one. That's why they're playing live for all of us this morning on the radio and on WFLD Fox 32. Good day, Chicago. Let's go back out there to that
right
loving
here,
crowd. Oh, right over
there. How are you? And our second question comes from Sandy Barney at one of the rowdier sections of the room. Sandy, what's your question?
My question is, I was wondering what song from your vast songbook you are most proud of.
Oh, that's a big question.
Good question. The room.
It's going to sound really corny, this one, but the title track of our new album is It Means a Lot to Glenn and I. We wrote it about an old friend of ours, and it's called Some Fantastic Place. So that's the one, I think.
You know, that's dedicated to a woman that helped you guys hook up. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that story? I mean, I don't think on the Chicago airwaves, we've talked about many things. We've never talked about you guys getting together and how it was Max, right?
Uh-huh. Was indeed. I put an ad in a shop window, as you do, and sorry.
It's a bit disconcerting.
Don't mind the man behind the curtain.
And I put an ad in a shop window for a guitarist to join a band that I supposedly had, but it was all fictitiousness. It didn't actually exist.
You were saying, I've got this fantastic band. We cover the Velvet Underground and
Glenn Miller and all sorts of stuff. And Glenn was the only one person to answer. Thanks to Max.
Maxine prompted me, because I have to point out that the advert did say that it was a fully-fledged band with recording contracts and touring.
I was ahead of my time.
And I thought, well, no, I'm never going to get that, so I won't reply. But Max said, no, go on, you should do it. So I did, and there was Chris and his sad little world with no band and no tour and no recording contract, but we got on anyway.
But a very nice guy nonetheless. We are live from Carlucci Restaurant. Has the food been fabulous this morning, ladies and gentlemen? Live from Carlucci in Rosemont, and I am looking forward to a big heaping portion of breakfast real soon. We are live with Difford and Tilbrook of Squeeze. We're going to play the first single from your new album and then come back and have you guys play a song or two live on the radio. I'm Lynn Bramer. The Breakfast with Bramer broadcast live from Carlucci's in Rosemont on 93 XRT Radio Chicago. Live from Carlucci in Rosemont, this is the Breakfast with Bramer broadcast with special guests Difford and Tilbrook of Squeeze in town for two sold-out shows. That's got to be a good feeling coming back to I almost feel like when you come here, you're coming home.
It's a very warm feeling. It's great. It's great that we're sold out.
Seeing you in your pajamas makes me feel like that, too.
Oh, you don't know how thrilled I was when they said, Lynn, the pajamas look good. TV will be here in 15 minutes. pajamas, television. There's a combination. This is a video cassette that won't go out to the parents. No, Mom, I'm still working at that bank. I don't know what you're... I know Uncle John called and said he saw me on television in a ridiculous pajama outfit, but that's just not the case. I am still working at the bank. God knows I'd never work in radio. This is 93XRT Radio Chicago. We are live here from Carlucci. We are also live on Fox 32. Good day, Chicago. Kurt Rivera, a big hand for Kurt. And since we have what I like to refer to for the first time, how can I like to refer to this if it's the first time, as the massing of the media, why don't you guys do what everybody has been waiting all morning for? Are you guys ready?
Yes, Lynn, I'll walk over here and tell you that we're going to be ready here in a second.
Oh, okay. So if you're listening on the radio and you're listening to dead air, you realize that this is for the benefit of everybody. Are you guys tuned up?
Oh, it was tuned up as we're ever going to be.
Tell us what song you're going to play for us.
We're going to play, to give us an element of continuity, we have Paul Carrack back in the band. We're going to refer, first of all, back to the last album that we did when Paul Carrack was with us, and we're going to play a song from East Side Story called Is That Love?
All right.
Excellent.
Are we ready? 1, 2, 3.
Now is that love? You cleaned me out, you could say broke. Now is that love? The better, better, better it gets, the more these girls forget that that is love. You won't get dressed, you walk about. Now is that a teasing glance? Says push me out. Now is that the tougher, tougher, tougher it gets, the more my lips frequent. Now that is love. Beat me up with your letters, your walkout notes. Funny how you still find me right here at home. Legs up with a book and a drink. Now is that love that's making you think? You caught my bluff, I'm not so hot. Now is that love? My assets froze while yours have dropped. Now is that? It's a cupid disguised. The more or less survive. Now that is love.
This is how solos used to be before the single string solos were invented. They just turned up the acoustic guitars and strummed their way through things, which is what we're doing right now.
beat me up with your letters, your walkout notes. Funny how you still find me right here at home. Legs up with a book and a drink. Now is that love that's making you think? You've made my bed the finger points. Now is that love? The more you cool down, the easier love is found. Now that is love.
Beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, Geoffrey and Tilbrook of Squeeze.
On Good Day Chicago. All right. And you guys, the new album is some
fantastic
place.
Indeed it
all
is.
Right. And you guys are fantastic. That's a new album to be playing tonight at the Vic.
Kurt
tonight
Rivera, Corona, ladies and gentlemen, right? Live on Channel 32, Fox 32, a sold-out show. Glenn Bramer here with a play-by-play. We were back here in 1924 for the first competition, and it was... Oh, okay.
Sorry, I just used your airwaves to do what I was supposed to do.
You can do whatever you want. We're going to take a break, listen to some fabulous commercials, and come back with some live Squeeze on 93XRT. This is 93XRT. I'm Aaron Bramer on WXRT Chicago. The Breakfast with Bramer broadcast with special guests Gifford and Tilbrook. Can I get you to put your hands on the radio or your champagne glass and give me It's an Great to Be Alive? Oh, man. Well, what an exciting morning so far. You said, do you have a little bit of adrenaline pumping through you?
Yes, there's quite a lot of adrenaline pumping around now.
Do you think you...
I definitely feel more awake than I would do normally at this time of the morning, I think.
Would this be about the earliest you can remember performing in a while?
I don't think we've ever done earlier, let's put it that way.
Top stuff on Glenn's voice, I'd say. I mean,
his voice sounded
like
great
that,
this morning.
Pretty good, I'd say.
And of course,
not the end yet.
Of course, ladies and gentlemen, coming up soon, a dramatic reading that will set the world on its collective ear. We bring you for the first time anywhere, Master Cheese Theater, starring Glenn Tilbrook and Chris Difford in the BBC production of Goodfellas. Coming up shortly.
He's sure about this.
I get the impression this has just been run by Glenn Tilbrook for the very first time. And that is the wonderfulness of live radio, ladies and gentlemen. Well, welcome back to Chicago. Two sold-out 93XRT shows at the Vic Theater tonight and tomorrow night. Now, I have to ask you this. I have to get it off my chest. You think about the Grateful Dead. Their keyboard players keep dying. Spinal Tap, the drummers keep blowing up. What are you doing to your keyboard players? I mean, I know you guys, you're not obnoxious. They even come back and play with you after they've left, you know? They leave, they come back. Another guy comes. He leaves, he comes back. What are you doing to these keyboard players? Is the practical joker Difford giving them hot foots in the tour bus?
What's hot foot? That sounds interesting.
Don't try this at home. They just come and go. Paul Carrick's back in the band.
He is indeed singing and playing really well.
He sings on the new album as well, and sounds good doing so. Mm-hmm. How would you guys like to entertain the crowd with perhaps a live selection?
Do we get to put our clothes back on now?
Before we do this, everybody... excuse me, listeners at home, this is just addressed to the audience here. We can all put our clothes on again now. Okay? Sir, please. Please. Everybody else is doing it. Just stitch up those pants. Yes, they fit beautifully. They really do. Okay, now that everybody's clothes are back on, we are ready to take you live to the stage of Carlucci and Rosemont here with the Breakfast with Bramer broadcast.
and a live selection from Difford and Tilbrook of Squeeze.
Okay. Third round. Right. One, two, three, four.
As much as I love you, as much as I care, I just can't pretend that the problem's not there. We know the boundaries from where we both stand. Our life has been happy without any plan. But now I feel sorrow as friendship turns stale. Our love's still on track, but without a third rail, without a third rail, without a third rail. The moon has gone up and the sun has gone down a million or more times since you've been around. Our life still goes on, but it won't be the same. Together, love only knows pain. With words that are tender, our love will prevail. But can our love go on without a third rail? Without a third rail? Without a third rail? White clouds appear like cotton wool, the wimpins choose to bow as we farewell this love of ours like some old sacred cow. As sure as heaven's above us and hell is down below, without a third rail to drive us, we'll have no place to go. There's a lump in my throat and I'm choked as I say, love has reached twilight, let's go in a day. We kiss on the platform, the doors slowly close, like theater curtains pulled out the show. We both know it's over, but somehow we fail. Love's going in circles, without a third rail, without a third rail, without a third rail. Without a third rail, 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 without a third rail. Oh, as much as I love you, as much as I love you,
woo! Oh yeah! Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, Difford and Tilbrook from Squeeze. The Breakfast with Braemar broadcast here, starring Difford and Tilbrook.
Thank you very much.
Yeah,
lovely.
You guys should do this every morning.
Yeah. I usually sound like this.
Coming up soon here live from Carlucci and Rosemont, the Breakfast with Braemar broadcast, we will be bringing you Master Cheese Theater and our adaptation of Goodfellas. You know, over the years, how'd you like that transition? Over the years, you guys have been described as the thinking man's rock band, desperately clever, almost as if it's a bad thing. I guess this is a career question. Do you have any notion of giving up thinking in the near future to please the critics or the?
Yeah, I wish you guys. It's a great idea.
I think it's definitely a suggestion we should think about.
Yeah.
I got to ask this because I love this business we call show.
There's no business like it.
There's nobody here from any record company, so put that out of your mind.
Yeah.
What's the dumbest thing somebody at a label ever? Because you always get advice, always saying, "Oh, why don't you wear funny clothing?" Or you know, maybe if you guys changed your name to Squeeze Bottle, you know, yeah. that would help. Anything like that ever happen to you guys along the way?
I'm trying.
Well, usually
they're stumped, ladies and gentlemen.
We got told when we put a tortoise on our album sleeve, Frank, not to do it. We should have listened.
And put, they were right.
No, we should have put two tortoises on it.
You know, over the years, when I've talked to you guys, you're kind of self-effacing. You like to make fun of yourselves. Do you guys have a problem with trying to run away from success? Do you see success coming and go, good God almighty, we don't want this.
We're out of here.
We're out of here.
No, not at all.
We're still looking for it.
I didn't think so.
In fact, if we could play 5 nights at the Vic, we would be very happy.
And so would the people of Chicago. You know what we're going to do? We're having so much fun that we're running a little bit behind schedule, and we've talked to Network. They're worried about Master Cheese Theater. We have to hit Master Cheese Theater so all our affiliate stations across the country and over in the UK can pick up the adaptation of Goodfellas. So what we're going to do, we're going to play a song going way back. This is a song that features Chris Difford prominently. You might remember this. This is a song on 93 XRT Radio Chicago called Cool for Cats.
This morning's presentation of Master Cheese Theater is made possible by a grant from the Big Oil Corporation.
Our oil is all over the earth.
Good morning, and welcome to Master Cheese Theater. I'm not Alistair Cook. This morning we continue with our adaptation of the cinematic masterpiece directed by Martin Scorsese, Goodfellas. The story of the Goodfellas is the turbulent tale of organized crime in the New York City of the mid to late 20th century. It is a story of fellowship, deceit, and men whose faces are kicked to an unrecognizable mush. A part of one of those kickers, Tommy, is played by newcomer and legendary singer of the band Squeeze, Glenn Tilbrook. And the lead role of Henry is played by fellow Squeeze, Chris Difford, who was last seen on Master Cheese Theater in the 15-part series Me, Claudius. In this morning's episode, we find Tommy in a restaurant where he has just given a riotous account of a violent encounter with a police officer. Goodfellas, Episode 6.
You're funny. You're really funny.
What do you mean, funny?
It's funny, you know. Good story. It's, you're just a funny guy.
What do you mean? The way I talk or what?
It's just, you know, you're sort of funny. You tell a story and everything.
Funny how? Well, I mean, what's funny about it?
It's just funny.
Hold on. Anthony, he's a big boy. He knows what he said. What did you say? Funny how?
Just this, all right?
What?
You're funny.
Hold on. Let me understand this, because maybe it's me. I'm a little screwed up, maybe, but funny how? I mean, funny like I'm a clown? I amuse you? I make you laugh? I'm here to bloody amuse you? What do you mean, funny? Funny how? How am I funny?
I'm just, you know, how you tell a story.
I don't know. You said it. How do I know? You said I'm funny. How the hell am I funny? What the bloody hell is so funny about me? Tell me. Tell me what's funny.
Get the hell out of here, Tommy.
I almost had him.
You bloody wanker. I almost had him. I almost had him. I'm worried about you sometimes, Henry. You may fold under questioning.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us for Master Cheese Theater and our special adaptation of Goodfellas. Join us next week for our adaptation by the BBC of Buffy the Vampire Slayer. This is 93 XRT Radio Chicago. We'll be back with more live Squeeze.
Welcome back to Carlucci. We are live from Carlucci Restaurant in Rosemont. We have, well, many of us have had a wonderful breakfast this morning, and we are joined by our special guest stars in town for two sold-out 93 XRT shows, Difford and Tilbrook. Chris Difford and Glenn Tilbrook.
Hey there.
So when do I get to meet Julia Robertson?
Oh, that's right. And there she is.
No!
Julia Roberts, ladies and gentlemen, has just entered.
No,
we were telling them that last year when we did a breakfast broadcast, Lyle Lovett was our guest, and shortly thereafter married Julia Roberts. We thought maybe there was a connection, maybe not. Maybe it's just a good karma thing, but whatever. You guys look like enough adrenaline and caffeine and coffee has pumped through you that we could. Do you think you could persuade them after a little break to play another song live?
Oh, okay then.
I never had any doubt. We're going to take a break. We're going to come back and listen to Difford and Tilbrook play a song live on the radio. The Breakfast with Braemar broadcast. It is great to be alive.
Live from Carlucci, it's the XRT Breakfast with Braemar broadcast, starring Chris Difford and Glenn Tilbrook of Squeeze. And now, here's
we are. It's 9:36 in the morning, live from Carlucci in Rosemont. I am Lynn Braemar, the live breakfast broadcast with special guest Difford and Tilbrook of Squeeze. Ah, what a morning.
What a lovely morning this is.
It has
super
been,
duper.
It has been just fantastic. Some Fantastic Place is the name of the new album. You want to tell us a little bit about what went into making the new album?
We built a studio basically, and then went and did it in there, the sort of old traditional fashioned way of, yeah, hello.
Aren't there easier ways to record? Okay, first thing we got to do, we got to build a studio. Then we have to buy some guitars.
Yeah. See, we're going stupid.
It's the new Squeeze. No more thinking man Squeeze.
Where does this bit of wood go?
But apparently you got it built because there is the new album, Some Fantastic Place.
Yep. And it was good because we could actually all, you know, it was a bit like sort of the old way of making records. We all sat around and worked out the arrangements and just set the tape rolling and recorded them.
Bunk beds?
No, not quite bunk beds, but what was good?
Cots with rubber mats.
Oh, my goodness. Well, you know what? There's not really a question that can follow the rubber mattress comment, so I think perhaps if you're ready, they should play another song live. 93 XRT, the Breakfast with Braemar broadcast. Why don't you introduce the song, tell us what we're going to hear, and blaze.
All right, this is from Some Fantastic Place. It's a track called It's Over.
Hey, wait a minute, that's not right. I didn't want this to cause a fight. Nothing new. Listen to me, believe it's true. What's there to hide? It baffles me. Throw out those thoughts of jealousy.
confidence, have faith. There is no attraction there. And believe me, this way I can wash it from my hair. Have confidence, have faith. There is no attraction there. And believe me, this way I can wash it from my hair. Hey, wait a minute, what's going on? I'm coming home where I belong. It's nothing more than face to face. Give me the time to pack my case. I know it's hard to let me go, but it's over. What's there to hide? It baffles me. Why should you waste your energy? But I won't leave if you're not sure. It's over. It's over.
Stupid song.
Ladies and gentlemen, Glenn Tilbrook, Chris Difford, Squeeze in town tonight and tomorrow night. Two sold out 93 XRT shows. We are live from Carlucci in Rosemont. The crowd is loving it. So are you basically screwed?
No, we're fine.
We've already broken a string on stage. Things are getting wild up here.
It was a lovely moment, but I'm gonna carry on. I'm gonna carry on this way. I'm gonna abandon the conventional style of playing guitar, turn it over on its head.
He's turning the. He's just gonna. Well, maybe you can keep that. You can keep that thought for a little bit later on when we do the Great to Be Alive XRT Wipeout Orchestra coming up to close the show. The back of a guitar would work nicely for that.
I'll save it for them. But I've a feeling I may be previewing it a bit before then as well.
Is there something else you want to do, or should we play a song? I shouldn't have asked that unless I was sure you were ready to go.
No, let's do one more. Let's do one more.
Should they do one more?
We're going to do Pulling Muscles from Michelle, I think. Yeah. All right?
Dangerous stuff.
One, two, three, four.
They do it down on campus and they do it at Waikiki. Lazing about the beach all day at night, the cricket's creepy. Screaming faces at the sky. A Harold Robbins paperback. Surfers drop their boards and dry, and everybody wants a hat. But behind the chalet, my holiday's complete, and I feel like William Tell made Marion on her tiptoe feet. Pulling muscles to Michelle. Pulling muscles to Michelle. Drinking from the sea so cold, topless ladies look away. A he-man in a sudden shower, shadows from the rain. You wish you had a motorboat,
a T-Rex,
to pose around the harbor bar. And when the sun goes out to bed, you hook it up behind the car. But behind my holiday's complete, and I feel like William Tell made Marion on her tiptoe feet. Pulling muscles to Michelle. Pulling muscles to Michelle. Two fat ladies, window shop, something for the man of peace. In for bingo all the nines, a panda for sweet little knees. Coach drivers stand about, looking at a local map.
about the boy who's gone away down to next door's caravan. But behind the chalet, my holiday's complete, and I feel like William Tell made Marion on her tittle feet. Pulling muscles in my shell, muscles in my shell. But behind the chalet, my holiday's complete, and I feel like William Tell made Marion on her tittle feet. Pulling muscles from a shell, pulling muscles from a shell.
Hey.
You're too kind.
Difford and Tilbrook live on 93 XRT Radio Chicago. The breakfast broadcast, the XRT After
Thank
80 weekend.
Much. I was just going to say, Glenn, do you know that Iron Butterfly song, Ina Garda De Vida?
Sure, Chris. Yeah.
Lynn does.
Glenn Tilbrook turning the guitar over after the broken string and just playing percussion along with Mr. Difford. And we'd just like to thank you for coming.
Thank you for having us.
That was amazing. That was really...
It's an absolutely fantastic way to start the day, I think.
This is the way you should start each and every day. And... really very exciting for me of all the breakfast broadcasts we've done over the years.
This
I think
is
you guys
one of them,
know.
Right?
This is one of them. trying to say something nice, he just...
It's their ongoing stupid.
You know, now. I used to like you guys. No, you know how we feel at XRT about Squeeze over the last, what has it been, 40 years?
Yeah.
The new album is Some Fantastic Place. Buy it for your friends, buy it for your relatives, buy it for strangers. We're going to take a break. Thanks for coming. Two sold-out XRT shows tonight, tomorrow
Thank
night.
You very much.
Thanks for having us.
Have these guys been great or what? Playing live on the radio.
You. Thank you.
Master Chief Theater, the adaptation of Goodfellas. This is 93 XRT Radio Chicago. We'll be right back after this with more.